It's worth noting that to this point, our approach at aiming torpedoes has relied on having the sights mounted directly on the torpedo tube, but it wasn't always possible to locate the aiming equipment near the torpedo tube. On larger ships, the tubes were often fitted below the waterline to fire out at fixed angles. On a battleship, this required that the torpedo director be moved somewhere else where it could again see the target, often to an armored control station toward the stern. With the director in a remote position, the geometry of our fire control problem has changed. The most critical measure of this change is evident when we notice that we can no longer see the target through the sighting wires when it is in the proper position for firing. But don't worry, we need look no further than a chalkboard for a solution. To start, let's draw on the corrected sighting angle and resolve to just move the rear sighting arch over so the wires are once again centered on the target when it reaches the proper firing point. We can place our sighting arch at any point on this sighting line, but which point should we choose? The engineers chose a place that was easy to characterize geometrically, as those choices are usually the easiest ones to represent mechanically and require the least thought to configure in battle. They extended a line from the mouth of the torpedo tube through the director's rear pivot point where the rear sighting arch had previously been mounted and found where this line intersected the new sighting line. The rear sighting arch would henceforth be placed here. This choice was wise for two reasons. First, the engineers had precise blueprints of the ship, and so the direction and distance between tube and director was simple to determine accurately and became a constant in all following calculations. Second, the small portion of this line which fell between the director's rear pivot point and the new sighting line corresponded precisely to the required movement of the rear sighting arch from the place it had previously been. The engineers created a direct analog to the short line segment by attaching a small arm called a tangent bar to the rear torpedo pivot point. The tangent bar could swing easily to any direction, and a small truck could be slid along it to establish the proper offset distance. The rear sighting arch was placed on this truck. The diagram indicates that the tangent arm had to be aligned to face the mouth of the torpedo tube. In practice, the torpedo men mounted a placard on the bulkhead of the torpedo control compartment to help the aiming officer orient the tangent arm correctly. Once we have the tangent bar properly oriented, we have to find the proper place for the sighting arch to be placed along its length. This arch rode upon a sliding truck that could be positioned against an irregularly graduated scale to match the estimated distance from the tube to the target. In the real world, we can envision a triangle formed by the rear sighting arch, the mouth of the torpedo tube, and the target ship in the firing position. A second, similar and smaller triangle is formed on the director with vertices at the rear sighting arch, the rear pivot point of the director, and the forward sighting arch. Let's label these two legs A and B using green letters for the real-world scale and blue for the analog. The proportionality of the length of the sides of these similar triangles then establishes that blue A over blue B is equal to green A over green B. If we solve this for blue A, we can determine that the distance we have to move the rear sight along the tangent bar is equal to the length of the director's sighting arm times the distance between tube and director over the range to the target as measured from the tube. Because the sighting arm is always the same length, and on any given ship the distance from tube to director is constant, the etchings on the tangent bar will describe an inverse relationship between the tangent offset and the range to target. And now let's try that all out in practice. We're on the deck. We're amidships on a massive battle cruiser, HMS Queen Mary. This is our key turret in the center of the ship. We can look forward. Somewhere up near the bow of the ship, right near the four turrets, is a submerged torpedo tube, and we're going to try to direct it against a destroyer over there. And to do that, we have to go to the torpedo control tower, which is near the stern, to give you an idea of the massive size of this ship and how far away our sight is from the torpedo tube. I'm going to walk and run us over to that torpedo control position. And there we are in the torpedo control tower. Go inside. The first thing I'm going to do, we have a pair of torpedo directors here. I'm going to click on and go up and use the rangefinder, which is mounted in the tower. Get an idea of the range for that target. Look through it. Find him in our rangefinder. Align the two halves of the image, and he seems to be 2,500 yards away. That's good enough for us. An approximate range is good enough in this application, actually. He's over there. We're going to configure our torpedo director. His inclination, I've got some heading and speed information from him that the people in the transmitting station have calculated. He's diverging 5 degrees from our course. That's an inclination of negative 85 degrees. He's making 18 knots. So I'll dial that in. Our torpedo speed is set correctly at 29 knots. Now we have to use the tangent bar, which is the new animal here. I'm going to rotate that so that it faces the bow of our ship, where our torpedo tube is. You'll notice the rear peep is on the truck, which slides on it. And now we're going to slide that truck to an in position that indicates it's 2,000, 3,000. We're going to put them out midway, 2,500. All looks pretty good. We've configured this sight. You can see that the tangent bar offset our rear sight a little bit. It's no longer on our sighting arm, but it's to the right. Now I'll look through the sights. Like, zoom you in a little bit. He's almost in the crosshairs, but he's fine. So we're ready to fire. Wait for the crosshairs to come into his midsection. Okay, we're going to fire. We're so far away from the torpedo, we don't even hear anything. At this range, it's going to take approximately, it's going to take over 2 minutes for the torpedo to run that course. Let's go outside and watch for it. We can see the torpedo in the water. There goes the wake. This is a fairly close shot. 2,000 yards, 2,500 yards. It's going to take 2 minutes. It would take a half hour to reload the torpedo tube below deck. That will give you a sense that if somebody was trained to do this, their entire career, their reason to exist as a sailor in a navy, they'd be lucky if they ever fired a torpedo in anger. Certainly, it would be a miracle if they ever fired two torpedoes. That's just how high the stakes were in aiming and firing one of these precious weapons. He goes out there. Fingers. Perfect. So our tangent bar worked.